goes down. They create their own culture with one language, one common language, that's English, with the various ethnic backgrounds. That's a multi-ethnic. But what is multicultural? This is not a new term. I mean, the new concept. But nowadays, there are missionary organizations, they separated this term out of multi-ethnic. Multicultural, people are born outside a country. That means what? Their primary languages are their own mother tongue. And then they adopt English as a second language and to communicate each other. But they speak their own languages. They just follow their traditions and their culture. That's the multicultural. So in other words, first generation is to be either bicultural or multicultural. And then as time goes by, second generations and third generations, they become as a multi-ethnic group. So this concept is not new, but all the terms we use from 20th century. Because there are so many people are now mingled together, blended in. Just like in this country. In LA, you know, generally speaking, the missionary organization, they just use about 269 languages here on earth. But that's not true. When we talk about the country India, how many languages are there? They say Hindi, but several, maybe 10 or 30 different languages. How about China? In Africa, they cannot communication. They cannot communicate with each other with the same language. We hear the same sound like the Chinese, but it's different. Cantonese, Mandarin, Filipinos, Tagalog. What else do you have? 36, right? See? Even one country, 36 different languages. Now I learned. So in generally speaking, about 270 languages are here on earth. But I want you to be challenged in LA. 220 languages are there, are spoken. It's more than 80%. Is that coincidence? God is doing something. But I only know that in New York, it's 188 languages are spoken. Very, very diversified in this country. Why? So the world becomes a multicultural. You know, let's turn to Daniel chapter 12. The last chapter, book of Daniel, verse 4. Did you find it? Let's read it together. But you, Daniel, keep this prophecy secret. Seal up the book until the time of the end. When many will rush here and there, and now knowledge will increase. Okay? Many refers to people. People will rush to come here and to go over there, traveling. That's the end times. And their knowledge will increase. Today's science technology, we go to moon, right? Even Mars. Surely this is the end times. That's why God brought all of us into this country to experience and to know what is going on. Okay? So, I like to introduce, this is not a new term. That's why the Genesis chapter 12. You know, before this chapter, God created heaven and earth and everything, human beings, and then He judged with the flood, water, and He saved the Noah's family to increase, multiply the human beings. And then, previous chapter, chapter 11, what is it? The Tower of Babel, right? And then, God spread all the human beings to different regions with the different languages. Anthropologists, they studied about 600 languages. God spread them out. But now, we don't know. The stats is about 270, but Tagalog itself is a 36. Chinese, Hindi, all together, we don't know. And then, all of a sudden, chapter 12, God is called Abraham. So right before the call of Abraham, the Tower of Babel, you just count. It's about 80 nations are there in chapter 11. And then chapter 12, all of a sudden the stories just flipped over. And then God is called Abraham. From the country of Ur, you are. And then he left. And he went to where? Haran. And then he moved into the promised land, Canaan. So what is God is doing here? So after the fall of sin, God's plan for salvation, He wants to do the multicultural ministry. Multicultural ministry means that God sends His people from one culture to the other culture. Full of examples in the Bible. The history of immigration. That's what God has done throughout human history. See, one of the classic examples is Joseph. Do you know Joseph? Right? Son of? Whose son is that? Jacob. We call Joseph as an unwilling missionary. He never wanted to go to Egypt. But because of brother's hatred, caused him to go to Egypt as a slave. They sold his own blood-related brother. So, God moved Joseph from the promised land to Egypt, foreign land. Why? He wants to introduce himself to Joseph, who he is. God said to Moses, when Moses asked God, what would I tell the people, the Pharaoh, that who you are? Then just go and tell him that